Welcome to Ron Wills Money Matters, making the gas in the car go further. This is significant. You know, yeah, I'll talk, get into like economy, small economy, starting a business, particular businesses. But one of the reasons I changed the title of this channel from About That Business to Money Matters is just managing money. And so whether you in business or not, I don't care what you do. If you got a vehicle, you need gas for it. And we all know what's happening to the gas. At some point, it might hit $6 a gallon. Now, the thing is, how can you stretch that? I mean, it's already tough enough. And see, the thing is, it's going to put a strain on some people. Now, I know it's already putting a strain on some people who may have to commute. Might have to commute a distance. Now, one thing they could do then, people need to seriously consider getting into more. Now, I haven't had to, like, I don't have to, you know, my commute is from my bedroom to the living room. But, you know, seriously consider carpooling, if they can, you know. And, in fact, I know in the D.C. area, I don't know if they still do it. I knew they did it decades ago, and they probably still do. Maybe somebody can enlighten me to it. They had specific carpool groups. Like from Northern Virginia into D.C. And sometimes the people wouldn't even know who they riding with. That's just how it worked. People need to look into stuff like that. If you're going to work or something, even especially if it's just a friend or something, and maybe, you know, bless the driver a bit or take turns driving, you know, something. Figure out some way and stuff. So that's just one basic one. One of the other things is the type of car that you have and the type of gas you use and everything. Make sure you use the right type of gas. Make sure everything is running right in your car so the gas is more efficient. It has to be very efficient and everything. Now, I use premium. I always use premium myself, so I'm paying the highest price. But I'm saving money because I don't have a commute. I'm usually driving around for fun. And one of the things with my car, too, is that it automatically stops when it comes to a stop. Like those kind of cars, they're great because a lot of people who have older cars that the engine keeps running at stops, now they're going to have a problem because they're still using up gas. That's still using up gas every time the engine is on. So, you know, that's one of the things. Now, unfortunately, from what I'm seeing, then there's issues with the price of cars going up and everything. It's always something, but we'll just stay focused on making it go further. Now, here's a little trick I've always used. Here's a little trick. Y'all don't realize how much I coast. I don't keep my foot on the pedal. I coast. If I'm going down a hill, I'll coast. I won't put my foot on the pedal. In fact, I still remember, this was back in the day. Let me share a quick story. Coasting can be so efficient that I remember I was going down a hill in Arlington, Virginia and stuff. My foot wasn't even on the brake. And I broke the speed limit. A cop pulled me over, said I was speeding. And I was like, damn, I was just coasting. It's like, man. But learn to coast. Learn. It's actually a style way of driving. I don't know how many people do it. And honestly, I thought it was normal, but it's something I do. I'll just gun it to a certain thing and then coast where I can. Especially if I'm going downhill. A lot of times my foot ain't really on the brake. I mean, well, on the gas pedal, you know. In fact, might be on the brake more. As a mechanic told me one time, I can wear out some brakes. But it helps it better. You're not using as much gas. Now, one of the things I'm not sure about personally, because a lot of people think if they use their air condition, they're using up gas. But then someone else said, no, that's just using up the electricity. I'm not sure about that. I'm not sure. If possible, check with your mechanic, check with a professional about that. I'm not sure. I've heard that. But in one of the things, though, whatever the case, I don't use it as much. I don't know how much that affects gas, but I try to limit it. But another thing you can do is you're going to have to do. All right, you can coast. Yeah, that's basic when you have to go someplace. Maybe carpool if you have to commute. Shoot, and indeed even take public transportation. But be real strategic when you have to go out. You know, be real strategic. You know, try to find the shortest path to wherever you got to go. That's the first thing. You know, that this in these times, you might not be able to take the scenic route. You know, you might not be able to take the scenic route. You find the shortest distance between two points. Because let's be real, we don't always do that. Because what we'll do, we'll drive someplace and we got to get someplace. But then we know there's some stuff on the way we want to see, stop by. You know, you have to take the shortest path. And then, like I said, be real strategic about when you go out. Be real, real strategic. Think, okay, how much do I need this? Like one of the habits I have, I don't buy a lot of stuff from the grocery store. I don't buy a big stuff at one time. I buy little stuff every day. That's just me. One thing about me, I don't like leftovers. So I buy just enough for that day. Maybe, dry goods or something that can last a few days, but very little that I can actually put in a refrigerator. One of the things is make it even more efficient. Like when you go into the store, make sure you get everything you need so you don't have to go to the store as much. You don't have to drive as much. Cut down on stuff. Limit what you're doing. Maybe just drive around one day, buy everything in one day, ends everything. And then, of course, you just have to make more money and budget. You know, you might have to cut from other stuff. You might have to say, you know what? I can't head to Ruth Chris. You know, that's going to be my go-to for just saying someplace to eat. Yeah, you might not be able to eat out as much, which, shit, that's another conversation. Let me go on a tangent real quick. I've been seeing some stuff at some places. They got signs up saying, hey, the prices had to go up because of the food shortage and stuff. I'm like, oh, my goodness. I'm like, place. But anyway, though. It's something to think about. It's something to think about. Where can you either bring up more money? How can you save that gas? How can you make it go further? Every little thing. Like I said, I've made gas go a long way. And that's been for years anyway. Because, I'll coast where I can. I'll coast. I don't keep my foot on the pedal, you know. Or even driving at a certain speed and everything. You know, even driving at a certain speed, a nice steady speed and everything, you know. And like I said, check with a mechanic on there. If there's any mechanics or anybody really familiar, let me know because I've heard both. I don't know, and I don't know for sure. I know a lot, but, you know, other than driving a car and doing some basics with it, I've never had a reason to know every single thing. So anyway. I want y'all to think about it. And look, I'm going to tell you what. We'll get through this. We'll get through this. And one of the best ways is to make that money. So let's go make that money.